All right, you're welcome to my Pixellab design class. This is an introductory video of the user interface of Pixellab. Okay, so in this video, I'll be showing you how the tools you need to know in this design, in this this app, right, so that you can work effectively. Okay, so let's start, let me move this down here. Okay, so we start from the up, then we scale to the downside here. Okay, so from the up, these are the tools available and their functions. Okay, so at the top here we can see the plus sign. So if I tap on the plus sign, you see the text. The text here is used while you want to input a text on anything you want to do. Okay, this is the current date. If you want to add date to any design you're doing, you use the current date there. This is sticker. If you want to input any sticker here, you tap on that. You see varieties of stickers. These are shapes. You can get shapes from here. Then this is gallery. If you want to add anything from your phone gallery, let's say logos, let's say icons, Facebook icons, all those stuff, anything you want to get from your gallery, you use that. This is if you want to draw anything, you can make use of this. If you want to draw anything, you can make use of this. Okay, so we are done with that. Then the next one by the side here is the save button. So if you tap on the save button, we have save as project. After designing, you save as project so that you can come back to do it later. Then save as image. After when you are done designing, you can save as image. Then the one by the side here is to share. If you want to share your work to anywhere, if you want to share your work, let's see, if you want to share your work to any social media platforms, you can share. Then this is smart mockups. Let me tap on it. Let's see what will happen. Couldn't find the app. You seem to have the app installed. Okay, you can save this image to a guy and share it from there later. All right, so if you want to share from many of these places, you can share. Then the one by the side here, which we don't use it most often, is called a quote. If you can, you can get quote from here. Okay, and input in your design. Let's say you're designing, you're writing quote on images, you can use that to do it. All right, so by the one next to it here, the three dots you see here, let me show you the functions. Okay, when you tap on the three dots here, it's the same function like this other one. Use image from gallery. You can import image from your gallery to your design to work on. Then full screen, if you want to view the full screen of what you were doing, you can use that. Okay, then we have the export image. The third one here is use image from camera. You can use image from your camera. All right, you can snap and design. All right, this is export image. You want to export image, it's the same thing as save. Okay, then the one here, contact us, report bug. We don't normally use that. If you have any issue, you can report to the app developer. Then the tutorials here, you can get tutorials, online tutorials on Pixellab. Then recover auto save. If you want to recover the file, this work you have saved before the recent work, you can recover from there. Then open the PHP file. If you don't use that, then the about and exit. Okay, then at the bottom here we have okay, we just want to rush this so that it won't be that long. Okay, so at the bottom here we have Pixellab. If you should tap on the Pixellab, it's just their logo, nothing will come up. Let's say you were writing something here and you made a mistake, you can use this to undo it. You can use this to undo it, or you can review. Okay, so let's say I type something like this. Okay, let's say I'm having something like this. Let's say something, just random text like this. Okay, all right, you can use this tool up here to redo it, to undo it. You can see undo any move I made, you can use that to undo it. All right, then this is the zoom. Okay, so if I should tap on this, I can zoom it, I can zoom something out just like that. Okay, you can pinch the screen and increase it, pinch and increase when this is selected. Okay, so that's the up one here. So you deselect it, then we have a ruler guideline. So when you tap on this, you can use the ruler. So at the bottom here we have the smart rule and the smart guide, then we have the ruler settings. So if I should tap on this and I move my text, look at the smart rule here, it's showing me that the red line showing is showing me that this text is at the middle of this page when the guide, when the smart guide is selected. Then the one by the side here is to set the rulers, okay. So let's say I choose this and I want to set this ruler to this place. You can set the ruler just like this, adjust this according to what you are doing. You can set the ruler just like this. All right, okay. Can set your rulers like this. You can use this for margin setting. Okay, so that's how to do that. Okay, all right, so the one close to it here is your layer panel. This layer panel is very important. If you tap on the layer panel here, so any work you have, anything you do here will appear here, your layers will appear here, anything you're working on. So let's say I should add another thing, let's say shapes. Okay, so let's say I add a shape. So you can see I will now have two layers in the layer panel. So you see this is the shape layer at the top here, the one that I add last. This is the shape layer, then this is the text layer. Okay, to move your layer up and down, you can do this long press on this dot you see here and move it down. It will move with it. So if I should long press on it, it will move just like that. Okay, so the text layer is now up while the shape layer is now below. Okay, so that's layer. Then at the bottom here, let's move to this place. Okay, so at the bottom here, the first thing here is my project. Any project you have worked on, it will be here. So these are the project I've worked on over the time. Okay, these are projects that I've worked on. So if I should tap on one like this, it will come up like this. It's a logo I did for someone. Okay, all right, okay, so let's go back to default. So that is how to get your project you have worked on, then which is this is selected. So anything that is selected below here will appear here. Okay, so if I should tap on this A here, which is for text, if I should tap on the A here, it's also for text, it's for editing. Okay, so it show me options to edit this text. Okay, so anything I do here will apply to this text. Okay, so if I should tap on styles, all right, you can browse styles. Right, so look at it. Oh my god. Okay, so you can browse out styles just like this. Let's see, I want to make use of this sample. Right, so you can browse out styles just like this. Okay, I don't know why my own this thing is doing like this, but all right, so you can get some styles just like this. Okay, so you can see edit, you can change the text, write another text. Here is delete, here is copy to front, bring it back to the front of anything. Then to back, we have position, relative position. We have to align it to the position to the center of this page. Then the size, we have padding, left padding, right padding, just like that. Okay, then we have the color, you can change the color to any of these. Then you have the opacity, reduce the opacity and increase the opacity. You can have the rotate just like that. Okay, you can rotate your text. Then you have the max, you can use the max just like this. That's what the max will do. Then you can change the font, any font of your choice you can get from there. Then this is bold, to make it bold, or any of this to change the background of this, give it a background of something like that. Can align it, center align, left align, is there spacing, space the word just like that. Okay, So here we have the stroke. You can add stroke to it, make the stroke more bolder, just like this. All right, then you can add shadow. It is shadows that make things look like they are 3D, but they are not. Okay, so we use that to apply 3D to our work. Then the inner shadow, you can add inner shadows, reduce, increase it just like this. Okay, can use that to apply some effect to your design. Then emboss, I don't know why my own emboss is doing like this, but okay, you can add some emboss to your design. You see the beaver. Okay, all right. So I have another class on this, professional class. For those that will take my professional class, I will give them that class. Okay, all right, you can use this to add some other effect to your design, some 3D effect which you can add to your design. Okay, you can add some 3D effect. All right, so that's that. The 3D shadow will be added. You can use that, then the reflection can make it reflect on the ground. All right, so those are the effects you can do there. Okay, so at the bottom here we have another stuff here. Then you have shape, you have stickers, import, draw, and arrow. You can select any arrow from here. All right, I teach that in my professional class for those that will take that. Okay, all right, so you can change the color of the background to this or any of this color. You can choose from, change the background color, you can change the brightness, you rotate, the change any of these settings just from here. The brightness, can increase the brightness to make it more brighter. You can use this just like that. Okay, then this is the rule. We use this to change colors of clothes or anything someone is wearing. Okay, so that's that. That's what we use those things for. And those are the settings. That is the introduction class on this. Okay, all right, so that's that. For those that will take the class, is ready, you can come and enroll and get it. Okay, so this is just the introductory class on this Pixellab to the user interface. All right, still remain your instructor, Nintendo Lacey Azar. Thank you.